So far, we've talked about the staff, the clefs, the notes, and the durations. These are the elements that are used to write a musical piece. As we know, even from experience, every piece of music has a rhythm. For example, we say this song is a waltz. It is characteristic that each musical piece is followed by an inner rhythm. It can count continuously 4 beats or 3 beats, etc. This is determined by the corresponding symbol at the beginning of a musical piece. There are also the vertical lines that define the musical measures, which always contain the same amount of beats following this initial symbol, and they are called bars. So, if I have a piece that is in 4 quarters, it means that every bar will contain 4 beats. Similarly, if they are in 3 quarters, then each bar will contain 3 beats. A little more complicated now. If the rhythm is in 7/8, it means that each bar will contain 7/8 notes. It is important to realize that in each bar there are strong and weak beats. For example, if we listen to this rhythm, we can easily understand that this is a 4/4 rhythm and the way it counts is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And this rhythm counts. The shortest distance between 2 keys is a semitone. Let us note that we must see the notes at the point where they all appear together, white and black keys together. We can have a semitone between a white and a black key, and between EF and BC, that we have white semitones. On the guitar, of course, things are simpler. We have semitone between 2 consecutive frets. 2 semitones in a row make a whole tone. The whole tone and the semitone are the units that we measure the distance, space, in music. Accidentals. The sharp, which raises the note, a semitone. The flat, which lowers the note, a semitone. And the natural, which brings the note back to its original state. Accidentals are written just before the note and mark the line or the space of this note. Let us note that the accidentals apply to all the same notes that exist after them in the same measure. For instance, we have a G sharp in this bar, so this G is also sharp, because it's in the same bar. These G that are in the next bar are normal. If we wanted this G to be white, we'd have to use the natural symbol. Other key elements in the writing of music. The symbol for repeats. The part that is included among these symbols is repeated. There is also the repeat symbol with the first and second volta, in which we normally we do the replay, and the second time we skip the first volta and go straight to the second. And we have also the senior and coda signs. These signs are used to repeat bigger parts of a musical piece. When we see the DS Dal Segno sign, we repeat from the senior. And when we see the two coda sign, we leave everything and go to the end where the coda sign is written. Dynamics is the symbols that determine the volume of the music. There are two main elements of tension. Piano is the low intensity and the forte that is the high intensity. And from there we have the graduations. Pianissimo, very low intensity. Piano, low intensity. Mezzo piano, medium low. Mezzo forte, moderately loud. Forte, strong. Fortissimo, very loud. Also, there are symbols of gradual increase and decrease in intensity. Crescendo, for increasing intensity, and decrescendo, for decreasing intensity. Speed. In most modern sheet music, the speed indicator is made this way. That directly determines how many BPM, beats per minute, will be executed. In the most classic sheet music, there are words that determine the speed. A bass directory is below. Larghetto. Adagio. Andante, moderato, allegretto, allegro, vivace, presto, prestissimo.